In this video, we're computing the volume of a solid of revolution that is formed by taking the curve cosine of x squared and the x and y axes on this given interval of 0 to root pi over 2 and spinning that whole region around the y axis, forming the solid that you see in the bottom picture below. We're asked to get the exact volume of this thing by using the shell method, so I've shown one shell with its symmetry axis lined up with the symmetry axis of the solid that we're trying to compute. Now each of these shells is identified by its right end, and I'm going to call that a variable point x. So when x is small, I have a tall skinny shell, and when x is large, I have a short and fat shell. Now given that this curve is y equals cosine of x squared, that means the y coordinate corresponding to this x value is given by cosine of x squared, and that's the height of the shell. The thickness of the shell wall is a differential quantity, we call that dx. And that's going to give me a differential volume contribution, the volume of this entire shell, which I'll call dv. So the next step is to cut and unroll the shell. And when I do that, it looks something like this. And we're going to compute the volume of this thing by using the formula for a rectangular solid. So the thickness of the shell again, that was a dx. The height of the shell, that was cosine of x squared. And the length of the shell, that's the circumference of the shell when it was rolled up, and that's 2 pi times x. So finding the volume of a rectangular solid is easy enough. I just multiply those three dimensions, and I have 2 pi x cosine of x squared dx. Now to find the total volume of the solid, I simply add up all the dvs. That's what the integral does. And the dvs are defined entirely in terms of x. So I'm ready to put limits of integration on this. I go all the way from x equals 0 to my terminating value of x, which is the right end of this interval. So that's root pi over 2. And the thing I'm integrating is 2 pi x cosine of x squared dx. So I notice that I have a function here, cosine of x squared. And the inner function is x squared. Well, the derivative of that is 2x, and I see 2x over here with a factor of pi tagging along. So I'm ready to just guess the chain rule backwards. If you wanted to do this formally, you would let u equal x squared, but I would rather do it informally and just pull out the pi. And whenever I see a function of a function sitting right next to the derivative of that inner function, I can just guess the chain rule backwards. So this must have come from the sine of pi x squared. As I'm writing that, I'm doing a little mental check that if I differentiate the sine of x squared, I get cosine of x squared multiplied by the derivative of x squared. That is what I started with, so it's good. I need to evaluate this thing across the endpoints. 0 to root pi over 2, and I end up with pi times the sine of root pi over 2 squared, which is sine pi over 2, minus the sine of 0. And sine pi over 2 is 1, sine of 0 is 0, so I end up with pi for my volume. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.